almost 1:10. So let's start with the topic, that is three-phase system. Okay. So I gave you the brief description of two types of three-phase system, right? One is the star connection, another one is the delta connection, right? And the star connection looks like just one Y, okay? Star connection looks like this type, okay? And this one is your delta connection, okay? Okay, just a minute. So, star connection, delta connection, construction is okay. Now, which one is advantageous in our case? In our case, the star connection is advantageous because it has the neutral point, right? We have one node. And as per the KCL system, we know that the summation of the current at any node is always zero, right? So, using that, we can calculate the current in each phase, right? And also one more thing, in star connection, the current in phase and current in flowing in the line is always same. That means IL equals to I phase. That is written here, okay? And the voltage, the line voltage equals to the root 3 times of the phase voltage. How you can calculate this? From the phasor calculation, from the vector calculation, right? So here, if you do the vector calculation, then here this is the vector diagram, okay? In this vector diagram, see, this NR, that NR, ENR, ENY, okay, and ENB, these are the phase voltages, right? And if you want to calculate the ERY, that is nothing but the vector subtraction of ENY minus ENR, right? So here ENY you already have here, okay, let me erase this one first. Okay, this is your ENY, or you can say EY, that is the phase voltage. And where is ENR? This is the negative extension of ENR, correct? In negative side, that's why this minus sign is here. Okay, this minus sign is present. That's why we extend this EN direction. Okay, then what we have to do? We have to do the vector calculation and we have to calculate the resultant, right? So resultant value, just calculate using the rule, okay? So that will be ENR square plus ENY square plus 2AB into cos 60. Why? Because here the 60 degree is the angle difference. Look, this is the angle difference between the ENR minus ENR and ENY. Okay. So after the calculation, you will get root 3 into E phase because ENR ENY equals to E phase, and that calculation is also done here. Okay. For your understanding. Now, so from here you can get the EL value equals to root 3 into E phase. Correct. So here, from here, I can say that the E line voltage in each case, whatever be our line voltage construction, suppose this is your R phase, okay, this is your Y phase, this is your B phase, okay. So if you take the line voltage value between R and Y, so ERY equals to root 3 of ENR, you can say, or ER, or I can say it is equals to also root 3 into EY, right? Also, I can say this one equals to root 3 into EB, correct? Because ER, EY, EB, these represent the phase voltages, correct? So from here, the star connection voltage relation is developed, correct? And the current relation is phase current always equal to the line current, right? Now, the direction is also shown here. Look here. Okay. So, is the concept of star connection clear, or do I need to repeat again? Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now we will shift to the delta connection. Okay. So in the delta connection, just a minute, I need to erase these parts, erase these drawings. So in delta connection, there is no star point. Okay. So there is one little disadvantage. Okay. Who is waiting there? Okay, so in star connection, we have neutral points, so our calculation becomes easy and it is safe, right? But in delta connection, it is little bit problematic, you know. Why? Because we have no neutral point, okay? And see here, here you can find one loop inside the delta connection. Here, inside one loop is present. Right. So, I can say that here, instead of using the KCL, we can use the KVL system. Okay. Now, because there is one loop, so I can use the KVL. Okay. Okay. So, what is the relation here? The relation here is line voltage and phase voltage is same. And line current in delta is root 3 into line, root 3 into phase current. Clear? So, how equation is developed? Okay. How this equation is developed? We need to find that using the phasor diagram. Right. So, take a look at the phasor diagram here. Okay. Now, the direction of current you can see here, IR, IY, and IB. Okay, so IR, IY, IB, these are the currents flowing through the lines. Correct? Now, ERY, that is the voltage between the R phase and Y phase, ERY. Okay, I hope you can see this. EBR, that is the voltage between blue phase and red phase. Correct. Now, they are written like this. Okay. E12 equals to ERY. Why? Because look, the triangle corners are named as 1. Okay. Try to understand slowly. This triangle is named as 1, 2 and 3. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, ERY, I can say it ERY equals to E12. Yes or no? Please reply.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what will I say as ERB or EBR? What will?
E13
or E31. Right. So, better to write a particular formation, okay, like 1, 2, 2, 3 and 3, 1. Don't say 1, 2, 1, 3. Okay, we are moving this path, okay, like R, Y, B. R to Y, Y to B. Similarly, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 1. A particular rotation you have to take. That will help you in calculation. I'm not telling you this one arbitrarily. Okay? If you take one particular formation, that will help you to calculate actually. Right? So, okay, so now you can generate the E12, E23 and E31, right? Now, the phase voltages are also same because in delta connection, phase voltage equals to the line voltage, correct? Okay, so you can say this line voltage and phase voltage concept is clear now, okay? Next one is the current. These three phase current, I12, I23 and I31, this one, okay, look at the red path, okay, this path, this is one phase, correct, one phase, okay, and which current is flowing? I12, so this is your phase current, correct. And see here IR, these are the line currents because this is one line, R, Y, B. Whatever current flowing outside through the R, Y, B, these are the line currents, okay? And whatever current flowing through each branch, that is the phase current. Like here, I12 is one phase current, okay? Here, I23 is the phase current that is flowing from 2 point to 3 point, right? Similarly, I31 is flowing. These are the phase currents, clear? And those phase currents are 120 degree separated. That means they are lagging in nature with respect to another, right? So here, next, look, this is your I12, okay, correct? Okay, let me draw the diagram here first. Okay, this is your 1, this is your 2, this is your 3. So, this is your 1, this is your 2, and this one is your 3. Yes, this one is your IR, right? This is your IR. So I am just writing only one. Okay, what is the phase current here? That is I12. Okay, what is the phase current here? Tell me, what is the phase current here?
2 3 2 3.
Exactly. What is the phase current in the red branch?
I31.
Now, you have the node here. Look, here you are getting one node. So, can you tell me the KCL for law? Can
you? I31 minus I12 is equals to 0.
Okay, let me write here I31. Yes. I31
minus I12 is equals to 0.
No, you are just ignoring the IR. Don't ignore IR. Okay? IR.
Yes.
Okay? So, if you do the vector subtraction of I31 to I12, then you can get the IR value. Okay? Clear? So, I31, this is your I, suppose your I12 is your reference. Okay? Suppose I12 is your reference. This is your I12. Right? Try to understand slowly. This is your I12. So, this one is 120 degree lagging. This will be your I23. Yes, and this is another 120 degree lagging. So this is your I31. Is the phasor okay? This is your 120 degree lagging. Is the phasor okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now you have the I31 value and you have to extend I12 in negative direction, isn't it? So I am extending this I12 in negative direction of same magnitude. Okay, now I have extended it. This is your minus I12. Now tell me, what is the angle between I12 and I31? What is the angle here?
60 degrees.
Okay. So now can you calculate the resultant value?
Yes, sir.
Resultant value. So it is easy. And what is your resultant value? That is nothing but your IR. Isn't it? Okay. So this IR is nothing but your line current. Okay, so IR is nothing but your line current. So now you can apply the parallelogram law, that is S root under of S square plus 2AB cos theta under root. Okay, so use that formula. Put all the values. Then you can easily avail this equation. Easily you can calculate this IL equals to root 3 into I phase. Okay. So ultimately what you already learned in 11 and 12, it is nothing but the application of that. ठीक है? So जो भी यहाँ पे calculation तुम लोग कर रहे हो, ये 11, 12 का just application है. देख रहे हो, this is the parallelogram law, isn't it? Okay, so from here you can calculate the line current, that is equals to root 3 into I phase. Okay, so similarly, if I am telling you that tell me the value of I y, so how you can calculate what is the value of I y? Okay, this is I r. So this is your I, Y. So at this point, take the KCL law. Okay, at 2 point, tell me the KCL law. Try to tell me the KCL law.
I12 minus I23.
Okay, good. So I23, okay, I23 plus IY equals to I12, right? So from here I can develop the IY value. IY equals to I12 minus I23. Is it okay? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now develop the phasor diagram. Here, look, I12 is present here, correct? I12 is present here and I23 is here. So you have to extend in negative direction, correct? I am extending it in negative direction. This is up to I23 with negative sign, right? Now apply the parallelogram law here. So whatever value you will get, okay, this one, this is your IY. Okay, so now you can develop the phasors on your own. Is the concept clear now? Is the concept clear to everyone or do I need to repeat? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
So now we are going to the advantage part. Okay, so what is the advantage of three-phase system over single-phase system? So in three-phase system, look, the number one advantage is the power to weight ratio of three-phase alternator is high as compared to the single-phase alternator. Okay, that means the generation for the same amount of electric power, the size of three-phase alternator is small. Okay, as compared to the single phase alternator, right? And the power delivered from the three phase system or power that we extract from three phase system is much higher because the voltage level is also high in case of three phase system like this. Okay, but in single phase, the voltage level is here. So you can get a rough idea that if voltage level is greater, then the power developed from the system or power extract from the system will be greater, right? So the power to weight ratio for three phase alternator is also high. Okay, and if you want to construct one three phase system, its size will get smaller with respect to the single phase system. Okay, so that's the first advantage. Second, for electric power transmission and distribution of same amount of power, the requirement of conductor material in three-phase system is less. Okay? Three-phase system is that's why called as economical system rather than the single-phase system. That's why you will see that if you visit any thermal power plant or hydel power plant, okay, like the Mython, okay, that is, they are supplying the power in three-phase system. All the that NTPC or the hydel power plants, all of them are sending power in three-phase system. And in three-phase system also, the transmission loss is very less, okay? You are seeing the tall towers hanging the wires, okay? So they are supplying the power in high voltage, okay, and the loss in three-phase system, three-phase transmission is so less, right? Now, third one. Now, here the power produced by single-phase supply and three-phase supply at unity power factor, waveform of power produced due to single phase supply at unit power factor is here. Okay, here you can see the power in single phase supply, that is V into I normally. Okay, and they are in phase, you can see this. So you can observe this green curve, that power is also the pulsating in nature. You cannot get one particular power, the power is also alternating in nature. But look at the three-phase system. In three-phase system, the power developed is always almost constant. So that's the advantage. Okay. Now, next one is number four. From the power waveform shown in these two figures, if alternating nature is present in the system, there will be vibration. Okay. And the vibration will damage the system, obviously. So, in three-phase system, this vibration is so less. It is vibration-free, actually. So, the lifetime of the system is getting increased. Okay, so these are the advantages. Now, next advantage is power-to-weight ratio that I already discussed, and the three-phase motor has better power factor with respect to single-phase motor. Next, three-phase system can use to feed a single-phase load, whereas the vice versa is not possible. If suppose a single three-phase system, okay, this is one three-phase star system, okay. Suppose if this wire is snapped, okay, due to tension, if this wire is disconnected, then what will happen? It will convert into one single phase system. Okay. It will convert into one single phase system. So that's the easiest way. You cannot supply the full amount of power, but some amount of power you can supply. But the vice versa is not possible. You cannot convert one single phase system into one three phase system. Okay. Next, if any fault occurs in any winding in three phase transformer, the rest two winding can be used in open delta to serve the three phase load. Okay. Like this here. Okay. This is the star connection. And if you take the delta connection, if this system is snapped, if this system is not working, then what will happen? You can transfer power using these other phases. Okay. So this is not possible in case of single phase transformer. So that is the disadvantage for single phase. Okay. So now we will solve some numericals based on the previous theoretical part. Okay. So first we need to find out the line currents provided the supply is balanced 100 volt, 50 hertz, three phase supply. Okay. So 100 volt, 50 hertz, three phase supply is present here. Look, this is the R phase. This is the Y phase. This is your B phase. Okay. Now this one is the R, B and Y. Okay. So it is connected in which formation? Delta connection is done. Okay. Delta connection is here. So in case of delta connection, what we already know? We know that V phase equals to V line, right? And I line equals to root 3 into I phase. Okay. So here phase values are given. Look, the phase, this is one phase R2B. This is your one phase, correct? And each phase has one particular impedance, right? So what is the impedance? Try to note it down. This is 6 plus 8J. Okay. Here, same 6 plus 8J. Okay. Now quickly convert this into polar. Okay. Now tell me how to convert it into polar.
6 sine theta plus 8 cos theta.
No, it is already in Cartesian. Look, we need to convert it into polar formation. That means R angle theta formation. Okay, it is already in Cartesian formation. Look here, it is already in Cartesian formation.
Root of under x square plus 1.
Right, root under of 6 square plus 8 square. Okay, and what is the value of theta? Tell me. What is the value of theta? How will you generate, how will you get that?
Y by X
and tan inverse, right? Because angle value you need tan inverse Y by X, right? I don't know why you just, you are getting confused, because look, this is your impedance triangle now. कैसे भूल गए? This is your impedance triangle. यहां पे हम लोग लिखते हैं the resistance value. Right? This is your 6 ohm. Okay? I am repeating it again. Look. And this is your XL. Right? What is your XL value? That is your 8 ohm. Okay? And now, this is your impedance triangle. Isn't it? This is your impedance triangle and this is your Z. Okay, this is your XL. So how will you get the z value? That is your r. Okay. So z magnitude is root under of r square plus xl square. That is 10 here. Okay. And what is your theta? This is your theta. So that is nothing but tan inverse xl by r. Tan inverse y by x. Okay, so this value is your 53 degree approx. 53.13. Is the conversion clear? Is the conversion clear now to everyone? Okay, so now this is your per phase impedance. Okay, I am writing here per phase, correct? What is your V phase value is already known. V phase value is your 100 volt, correct? Okay, V phase value equals to V line value, that is already 100 volt. So how will you get the I phase? The I phase value is V phase by your Z phase. Okay, so this is the value of the phase current. Okay, that is the value of the phase current. Is it now clear how it is developed? How we are getting this answer? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Okay,
fine. So now we are going to the next numerical. Okay, these are the other branch currents, other phase currents. Okay. Now, the phase current value, if you know, you can easily calculate the line current also. How? Root 3 you need to multiply. Okay, so phase current magnitude is 10. So if you multiply root 3 value is 1.732. So ultimately you will get this equation. 17.32 ampere is your line current. Okay, so now next numerical. A balanced three-phase load draws the power of 8 kilowatt at lagging power factor of 0.8. Okay, if the line voltage applied is 440 volt, find out the complex power and the line current. Okay, so what we have to calculate? We need to calculate the complex power. That means S we have to find out. And what is S? That is V plus, tell me, JQ. Okay, what is P? What is P?
Active power.
Active power. What is Q?
Real power.
Yes, sir.
This is your active power. Or you can say real power. This Q is called the reactive power. Okay. What is the unit of reactive power?
Var.
Var. Exactly. Good. So, P value is already given. Look here, 8 kilowatt. Because active power unit is watt. Okay? And reactive power unit is var. Right. So here active power value is already given. And the lagging power factor is 0.8. So what is the value of power factor? Power factor is nothing but the cos theta or cos phi here.
50 seconds.
Yes, sir.
So cos phi value is here as 0.8. Okay. Now, in place of P, what I can say? In place of P, can I say that S cos theta or cos phi equals to P? Can I say it? Because this is your P. Okay. And this one is your Q. This is your Q, right? And this one is your S. So can I say S cos theta equals to, or S cos phi equals to P? Can I say it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So S value you can find out from here, because cos phi value is already known to you, that is 0.8. So what is your S magnitude? S magnitude is 10. Yes or no? So S magnitude if 10. So from here, calculate the value of Q. What is the Q value? That is S into sin phi. Can I write it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So Q equals to S sin phi. What is your S value? That is 10. Cos phi value you know, that is 0.8. So how will you calculate the sin phi value? Cos square phi plus sin square phi equals to 1. So from there, calculate the sin phi. Okay. So sin phi value is root under of 1 minus cos square phi. So this value you will get as 0.6. Okay. That is 0.6. So 10 into 0.6. That means you are getting 6 var. 6 k var. Because all the units are in kilo. Okay. So now you can tell the complex power. What you can say, that S is our complex power equals to P, that is 8 kilowatt, plus J into 6 k var. Okay. Or if you want to convert this into the polar formation, then you can also tell this as 10 angle 36.8 degree KVA. Is this okay to you? Is this okay to you? Yes or no? Reply.
No, sir.
Polar form, not understand.
Okay, from where?
Polar form, sir.
Polar form. Okay. So this part is okay. This concept of P and Q, this triangle is okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So from power triangle, I am writing S cos phi equals to P, right? So from there, P value is already known to you. Okay, that is 8 kilowatt. P value is your 8 kilowatt. Okay. Cos phi value is 0.8. So you can find out the magnitude of S. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is Q? In place of Q, can you write S sin phi? Yes or no? What is sin theta? Sin theta is basically the height in numerator, in denominator, there will be hypotenuse. Yes? So S by Q, this is Q equals to S into sin phi. Can I write it? This one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So S value you already know, that is 10.
Yes.
What is sin phi value? Cos phi value is already you know, 0.8. So sin phi value you can calculate easily.
Yes, sir.
So now you can multiply, you will get the 6 kVAr value. That is the reactive power. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, so, yes?
Sir, how we get to 36.8 angle?
36.8, this cos phi is 0.8. So how will you get the phi value? Cos inverse 0.8?
Yes, sir.
So from there you will get the value? 36.8 degree. Here it is the cos inverse 0.8.
Okay, sir.
Okay?
Yes, sir.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, aapne 54 or 36 ke ratio mein angle divide kiya.
क्या फिर से बताओ फिर से बताओ
P और Q का जो वो है perpendicular 90 degree वाला angle उसको आपने 54 और 36 के ratio में divide किया तब वहाँ जाके 36.8 kVA आ रहा है
no that's not the actual logic. The logic is this power factor value. This power factor value is 0.8. Okay, what is the power factor? That is cos phi, cos of the angle. Okay, so from there you are getting this 36.8 degree. I am not intentionally doing anything. Okay, this value is already given. That 0.8 is already given to you. That's why you are getting this degree. If I change this to 0.7, obviously you will get some difference. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now, P and Q, all the details you have now. P value is 8 kilowatt. That is P value here. Okay. P value I am writing here, 8 kilowatt. And Q value you already calculated, that is 6 kVAr. So this is the complex power. That's how you are getting it. Is that okay now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So from here, you can calculate the complex power. So this is the rectangular form or Cartesian form or complex form, and this one is the polar formation. So you can express in any formation. Both are equally correct. No one will give you any cross mark. Okay. So complex power you just calculated. Next one is the line current. Okay. So how will you calculate the line current? The line current will be calculated using this formula. See, the power in three phase system is root 3 into VL into IL into cos phi.
Are you more into Java and you like
theta? Okay, that is the active power equation. P equals to root 3 VL IL cos phi. Okay. Or you can say that S equals to root 3 into VL into IL. This equation you need to remember. Okay. So if S equals to root 3 VL IL, so that you can say P equals to S cos phi. Okay. Is the concept clear? The power concept, the how to calculate the power?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the P value is what? 8 kilowatt. Okay. Root 3 into VL value you already know. That is already given here. Look, VL value is 440. Okay. So VL value is 440 volt, correct, into IL, that is line current, which is unknown, correct, into cos phi. What is the value of cos phi? 0.8, isn't it? So from here, calculate the IL value. You will see the same value you are getting. Okay, here which equation this numerical follows? This numerical followed this equation. S equals to root 3 into VL into IL. Okay, this equation follows this formula. Okay, but some of you can follow also this formula because P is also known to you. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the numerical and this one is another numerical. Okay, take one snapshot. If you can solve it, solve at home and take the snapshot and upload the answer in WhatsApp group. Okay. Have you taken the snapshot?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, fine. Sir. So try this one. Otherwise, in next class, I will obviously discuss this numerical. Okay. So the power calculation concept is over. And in next class, the only numericals will be solved, okay, based on the AC circuit, different kinds of AC circuit, correct? So with this, I am concluding today's class. Thank you, everyone. And everyone, give your attendance in the chat box. And if you have any kind of query, please speak.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.